Do I really have to hold my pose for this long? Okay, that was totally worth it. Hey everyone, welcome back to DIY in 5. I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and in this episode of DIY in 5, you'll learn some tips about the slow but beautiful art of long exposure photography. If you're brand new to DSLRs, make sure you check out our previous videos on ISO, shutter speed, and aperture to help you set up your camera for these long exposures. The first one is probably the most important. Keep your camera steady. Besides the camera, having a tripod is your greatest asset for long exposure photos. Shooting by hand is just not possible unless you have the rock solid demeanor of the thing. Any minor movements or vibration will cause your photos to come out blurry and unusable. A tripod will keep your photo crisp, clean, and worthy of using as your desktop wallpaper for years to come. For an added bit of safety, you can use a remote trigger. Even pressing the trigger too hard can result in a blur with long exposure photos. This can be especially problematic when shooting on a lightweight camera or a smartphone. Next, plan it out. Preparation is key for these photos. Long exposure images achieve the greatest results when you plan ahead. Unlike lifestyle photographs, where much of the greatness can come from capturing unexpected moments, long exposure photography is ideal for landscapes and cityscapes where your subject isn't moving. If you're interested in shooting long exposure for light painting, you might want to check out this video we did over on IndieHack. For traditional long exposure photos, paying attention to detail and composing your picture for interesting architectural angles or capturing the galaxy in the night sky will create the best and most interesting images. The unexpected benefits will be seeing all the unique and interesting lights that show up in your photo that you didn't readily see with your naked eye. Speaking of light, make sure the light in your photo is really the light you want to see on the final image. One of the biggest offenders for light leaks is from your viewfinder. You know, the little peekaboo window where you line up your shot. Anytime you leave your shutter open for long periods of time, the light can actually come in from both the lens and your viewfinder. Make sure you bring along a bit of black tape or something similar to cover up the viewfinder. It's good practice with long exposure photographs to actually use the preview screen instead of the viewfinder. We hope you're enjoying all our DIY in 5 photography tips. Let us know what photography questions we still haven't answered in the comments, and be sure to check out these other great photography videos while you're here. Okay, one more cheesy photography joke before we go. Reasons everyone should date a photographer. They know how to focus, can do it in the dark, and work well from many angles. Booyah!